Now that we've set up your attendance module in your classroom, it's time to take attendance. You do this, of course, going into your classroom and clicking on attendance. This will usually land you on the current day. That's not the day you need to take roll for. You need to click on the calendar on the right-hand side here. This will bring up a calendar. You can scroll between the months, find the locate the date that you need to take attendance for, and click on that date. I'm going to go back to Monday the 24th here. I have only 3 students in my little fake class here. I can mark them all present. Find individual ones and then toggle between absent or late. If I want to see more information, I can click on more and see more information about this class, this student in this class. All right, so right now I've only taken attendance for one time and that person I have marked as late. And I can see, because I did leave this as for grade, that she's currently at 80%. Now, if I want to, I can go to the next date that I want to take attendance. And again, I can mark all students present, and then I can toggle through. Let's make this person absent. Again, one by one, I can go through and take attendance. I'm going to take attendance every day this week and then just show you the results at the end of the week, what it might look like. I can still kind of go one by one if I want. Ima is always late. Ima too. All right, and last but not least, I have my last day. Let's make everybody came to class on Friday. All right, now, so what I can see here is if I click on the more, I can see that this student was present 5 days. If I click on the more on Ima 2, she was present 3 days, but late for 2 of them. And last but not least, Ima was present for 4 days and absent 1. All right, so you can one by one go and see what each student is doing. Also, if you have different sections set up in your classroom, you will see that there's different sections across the top here, but I only have one section in this classroom, so that's why we only see one here. Now, moving forward, the next thing you would like to know is how does a report on this attendance look? Not as grand as you would hope, but there is an attendance report. If you click on this attendance report, it will create a CSV file that you can then data mine yourself. I click on that, I can choose a start date and an end date, and then tell us where to send it. If you want to send it to us somewhere other than the default, you need to put that email there. I'm just going to leave the states blank here and run the report. Now, I did this earlier so that you could see what this looks like. So I'm going to open up the spreadsheet that was sent to me and show you roughly what it looks like. I cleaned it up just a tiny, tiny bit just so that you can see. So we do have a report here and list each student. It just goes straight down from the first date you took attendance to the last date. If you know how to do a little bit of data mining, like turning your filters on and you can start sorting maybe just for one student and see their late and present, you could do a couple of little things in Excel to data mine. Unfortunately, that's the limitation of this attendance module. That's all that you can do as far as a report for it. There is another feature called badges. I'm going to do a third video on that because it's a little peculiar and it does not actually give you any data, but I do want to tell you about the feature just in case it's something you want to use. But for now, for as far as taking the attendance, you just click on the attendance, find the date that you need to take attendance for, and mark your students. All right, any questions, you just contact the technology trainer, be willing to help you.